Validating IT response processes in digital competence assessment through eye tracking techniques. Nowadays, there are no doubts about the importance of validation and recognition of digital skills, but most of the high-stake assessments currently being used for evaluation and certification are based on self-assessments not covering all the digital competences and are focused on low-order cognitive skills. Even more, there is a strong connection between the student's performance and engagement and how the tasks and the assessments are designed. So, it's crucial to correctly design the evaluation items to trigger the intended knowledge and skills. What is validation or response processes? Response processes refer to approaches and behaviors of examinees who interpret assessment situations and formulate and generate solutions as revealed through verbalizations, if movements, response times, or computer clicks. Such response process data can provide information about the extent to which items and tasks engage examinees in intended ways. Even more, is one of the 5 sources of evidence according to the standards for educational and psychological testing, and is essential in the development of new assessment formats. Traditional sources or response processes evidence are cognitive interviews and think-aloud interviews, but there are other methods such as eye tracking, response times analysis, or tracking of responses. Unfortunately, the use of examinee response data in test validations is scarce. Eye tracking technology. Eye movements are essential for cognitive processes, and most of quantitative metrics are based on fixations, and qualitative analysis are usually based on heat maps and gaze maps. The objective of the study was to find a set of metrics that could help test designers to validate them understanding the interaction of participants with the tests, and to analyze how these metrics can vary among participants of different levels of digital competence. Methodology. For the students, 50 workers from technology research and innovation participated in the study. Their backgrounds differed among their competence profiles in the company. They had to complete 6 different tests available on these websites. The tests were based on DICCON. Different formats were included, multiple choice, image-based, simulation, and open tasks. For the study, we used a standalone and anonymous eye tracker. For each test, it started with a calibration process, and then all the participants have to resolve the same task in the same order. Results. We started analyzing the scores and later response times, and found that unsuccessful participants spent at least 25% more time on the task. From the eye tracker data analysis, we found that unsuccessful participants performed more fixations and spent more time on fixations than successful participants. Results, supported by heat maps and gaze maps, contributed to validate that the assessment criteria defined was correct and served to differentiate users of different levels. Then we carry out a statistical analysis, and we perform a man-witness U-test to compare the two groups, and the results reveal significant differences in response processes between participants who passed and did not pass the tasks, with the former having lower average response times, areas of interest fixation count, and time of interest duration. Conclusions. The quality of assessment task is a determinant of learning, and considering that the students design their learning activities on the basis of how they are going to be assessed, assessment itself needs to be well designed. So we use eye tracking observation to fill the exploratory gap by providing data on variation in item response processes that are not captured in traditional computer-based assessments. We wanted to confirm that eye tracking data can contribute to the test item validity, exploring specific patterns of eye movements of participants to make detailed observations of item response processes in an evaluation on digital competence. We found significant differences between the participants who correctly solved the task and those who failed, in terms of time spent on solving them, as well as the data on the races. Included insight into response processes, we contributed to validate the design of the evaluation items, presenting evidences that the items triggered the intended knowledge and skills, and contributed to validate the assessment criteria of each item. In addition, it helped us to detect critical steps in the simulations, as well as to obtain additional information that allowed us to adjust level of difficulty of the items. That's all. Thank you very much for your attention.